I had previously submitted a memorandum to my colleagues, to yourself and my colleagues, in which I noted that it took me most of this budget cycle to understand what was happening in the library district. I couldn't figure out why, if we were just going to maintain the tax rate flat, that we were all of a sudden going to lose so many hours of operation and so much service in the libraries. And then it dawned on me, I think at a meeting yesterday for the first time, what had happened, because I had only been here for a couple of years, in which the millage rate had always been around 0.17. Then I realized that two things had been happening here for about 4 or 5 years. One was that we were using surpluses from prior years to make up for the reduced millage rate of what's been going on for the last 5 years, where it's gone down from 0.38 to 0.17. That's a 56% reduction in the millage rate. How can we maintain a decent library system with that kind of reduction? And so what seemed to me to be simply keeping taxes flat, actually somebody else used the term flatlining. I don't know if they meant to use flatlining, but that's really what it is. I'm extremely impressed. The clerk here to my right at one point said of the presentation made by those who are advocates of the library system that it's the most impressive he's heard in many years. Certainly it's the most impressive that I've heard in 2.5 years of being here. Well, it's less than 2.5 years. It just seems like it's like 25 years. But, I was impressed by many of the quotes. Eugene, whose name, last name, I think is Chen or Chan, and his name means well-born, by the way, and that's something you learn in libraries. But anyhow, he had some great terms about libraries being a temple of learning, a place where you go to understand the universe, and a place where you go to find yourself. When he said that, one of my staff members behind me, I won't say which one, whispered to me, "I go to the libraries to find myself," which is kind of curious because he spends most of the time on his iPhone, so I'm not sure that that's not a little bit of an exaggeration, but he certainly seemed to be as convinced as I am that we're going in the wrong direction. And I said in my memo, Madam Chair and colleagues, that I didn't see that it would be right to change my vote because it would lead to, if a majority of us did, or if a majority of us voted that way, to having to send out the trim notices. That's $0.75 million. But what really worried me more than that was the disruption in our budgetary process of having to restart the entire process. Actually, now I realize that for the library by itself, the library district, it's not really a complicated matter. It is a $0.75 million hit, in which maybe we can find some money from the dolphins that were left there, you know, $2.5 million. I thought that was a great idea. Oh, okay. Well, it's been used up. Anyhow, we'll find $700,000, which is a fraction of 1% of our budget. And there won't be much disruption because it's only one department. And what there will be is the opportunity to set right something that was done wrong for the last 4 or 5 years. And I just have not realized it until I looked closely at the numbers. I couldn't figure out why, if we were keeping taxes at the same rate, we were reducing by, you know, 160, 170, 180 our personnel in the library department. And I am now convinced and ready to vote with the group that wanted to increase the tax rate for the library district.
Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Chair.
Before I